Hey everyone, what's going on? Nexius here, bringing you guys 100 Nightmare Countess Magic Find runs. Now, unfortunately, I died in Hell Lower Kurost on my previous source, so this is source number 3, and because she is a very fresh sorceress, I don't have things like spear and whatnot. Well, actually, I have spear in this clip here. I actually got lucky and found a four-socket broadsword, but my point is here is if you don't have a stealth, a spear, or anything decent, Nightmare Countess can be good to start off with those early rune words. For example, I don't have the Shale-Eth Rhyme rune word here, so the point of doing Nightmare Countess is to find yourself some quick runes to make some early on good progression rune words, whether that's Spirit Sword, Stealth Armor, Smoke Armor, Treachery for your Mercenary, Ort Soul, which is lore for the Helmet, Rhyme Shield, things like this. So the purpose of doing the Countess is particularly for these targeted specific runes. Additionally, Hell runes are a pretty decent target as well, in case you want to reroll spirits. For example, the spirit I'm using now is a crappy lowest 25% cast rate. At least if I want to go for a higher one, I can reroll with all of my Hell runes that I find, hopefully, through this run. So enough talking there. I hope you guys are paying attention to the gameplay since I haven't really been covering what's dropping, but you can see here I'm getting a lot of Shales, Eths, Tal or Ral, Eth, Ith, all these different low level runes, and the main reason for this is, like I said, to pick up the Hell runes and the early on rune words such as Spirit. Now, one thing I want to know here is that about 2 or 3 ladder seasons ago, so maybe about 1.5 or 2 years ago, one thing I decided to do one ladder season was farm only Countess and Nightmare Cows and see how much forum gold I could make off Spirit Swords and Insights. So that was my goal in one of the ladder seasons, just for fun, to see how much profit can I make specifically doing Countess and Cows on the first day or two of a ladder season, and how many spirits and insights can I make and make a profit. I ended up making about 1500 forum gold off. When I did this challenge a couple years ago, each spirit was going for about 250 forum gold, and the insights were going for about 100 to 150 forum gold. And of course, I made a couple of those within the first day. So it was a pretty decent profit if you're looking for that day one profit instead of relying on Hell Mephisto. But overall, I wouldn't really do it now because I tried it again about 1 year ago, 1 or 2 seasons ago, and they didn't really work out. The spirits went down to 50 forum gold almost instantly. So overall, I wouldn't really recommend doing this if you're looking for profit when it comes to Battle.net. But overall, if you are, say, like me, playing single player, and you are looking for some quick runes to make, maybe an Honor if you're a Barbarian or a Zealer. Honor is a really good level 27 melee weapon. If you want to make an Amazon bow, there's a couple. There are a lot of good rune words. You just need to look them up that require these runes. And the Countess is a very good way to farm them early on without really threatening yourself. Now, one thing about noting here is what's the difference between normal and Nightmare Countess? And it's only a few select runes, maybe a Lum rune, maybe a Lem rune, maybe something like that. Well, unfortunately, I did not find a single Lum or a single Lem in this run here. 100 Countess runs, not a single Lum or Lem. Very disappointing. So once this run actually concludes, I will give you guys a summary. I do want to do this one a little bit different at the end. And what I want to do is I want to let you guys know what my goal was when I was doing Nightmare Countess and what the results were in terms of how many particular runes, how many spirit runes did I make. Out of 100 runs, how many spirits can I make? How many insights can I make? How many rhymes can I make? That's what I'm looking for in this Magic Find run. So in this Magic Find run, I'm not just going to do what I did in the previous videos where I just said, hey guys, here's 100 runs, here's what I found, the end. What I'm actually going to do in this video is I'm going to show you guys how many spirits I'm able to make after 100 runs. So if you are looking to make, say, 10 spirits, you know, maybe this would be good for you or anything of that sort. So if you think it might be profitable, well, hopefully this video helps you kind of answer that. Keep in mind, this is Nightmare and not Hell mode, so anything like a Mal or higher or an Ist or anything like that, very, very rare. Like I said, I didn't even get a single Lum or a Lem in this, not even a Ko. The highest rune I found was 1 or 2 Io's, I think 1 Io actually, and then like about 5 to 7 Dole runes, 5 to 7 Hell runes, something like that, I think. I'm just going off the top of my head. I will definitely have the information in a word pad at the end of this video. So as you guys are seeing here, I'm kind of like showing you guys here, not every single rune, but basically what I'm showing is the first 8 runs, were the runes I was looking for. So spirit, rhyme, stealth, lore, anything like that, insight. In the first 8 runs, I found almost every rune to make every single one of those. So you really don't have to spend a lot of time doing Countess if you are only looking for rune words for yourself. If you're looking to make money off spirits and stuff, of course you want to keep running it. But if you're only looking to gear yourself early on with a spirit, stealth, and rhyme, well, or and an insight as well, then basically you only need to do about maybe 8 to 15 runs tops. At least that's how it has been for me the last few times I've had to make a couple of these sorceresses in hardcore. Now, additionally, on what I'm showing here is triple rune drops. There were quite a few triple rune drops. Every like 5 or so runs, I'd get one. So if you're looking for a maximum amount of low runes to sell, she's pretty good, even on players 1, dropping 3 runes, usually 2. I think this might be fact. I don't know if it's a myth or a fact or anything like that. I forget. I didn't really look it up. This is just something off the top of my head from years ago. But one thing I remember hearing when I was playing this game growing up was you want to play on slash players 1 for this. You don't want to be in a 8-man group or 8-man game. You don't want to be in a 5-man game, or in terms of single player, slash players 5 or 8. You want it on slash players 1 or by yourself, because the more people means the more drops that can replace the runes, because the way Countess's loot table works is really weird. So you want to have it on slash players 1 because she's almost always guaranteed to drop 1 or 2 runes, and a very odd chance that it's going to be a third rune. The third rune usually comes from the loot table, not the rune table that she has. And the more items she drops, the less runes she will drop. And you are magic finding her specifically for the runes. Alright, so let's take a look here at all the runes I actually found. Well, I talked a lot for about 6 minutes already. Wow, time flies. I might have been talking a lot, but that's because, you know, this is like a 6-minute video. So I had to throw something in while 6 minutes is going by, showing you guys all the rune drops. So I went from page 22, I think 22 or 23. And you can see all of these runes here. I mean, look at all these Tal runes. I have at least like 4 stacks or 4 lines, which is about 30 or 40 Tal runes. It's crazy. These are all the runes from 100 Countess runs. You can see it all right here. Some of them are pretty rare, like Eld, El. A lot of very common ones here, like Sol, Tal, Ral, you know, the typical spirit insight runes. A couple of Hell runes there. Yeah, see right there, 3 lines of Orts, 2 lines of Am. You know, there's so many low runes here just from the 100 runs. So I'm just showing you guys here. All right, let's skip all of this and let's take a look at the word pad. I think you guys have seen enough of the gameplay. Let's take a look at the information. So with the first word pad I have here, is this is what I was looking for, and this is what I assume players are looking for when they want to do Nightmare Countess. When you do Nightmare Countess, you pretty much have no gear. So what are you looking for? You guys and myself are usually looking for a early spirit, an early insight, an early rhyme shield, an early smoke if you can for yourself or your mercenary, or even better, an early treachery for your mercenary. Now, as you guys can see here, I noted what run I found each particular rune. So on run 1, I found a Tal rune. On run 8, I found a Thal. Run 3, I found an Ort. And run 6, I found an Amd. So it took me 8 runs to make my first spirit. In terms of insight, run 4, I found my first Ral. Run 7, I found a Tear. Run 7, I found my second Tal to use after spirit. And run 8, I found a Soul. So again, within 8 runs, I was able to get the runes for both insight and spirit at this point. 8 runs is pretty quick to go by, so it's very easy to get these two particular targeted rune words. Next, we have Rhyme. Run 3, we had the Shale, and run 5, we had the Eth. So again, underneath 8 runs to get 3 rune words, as you can see here. Now, in terms of smoke and treachery, I knew these ones were going to be a challenge. We found the Neph on run 13, and we never found a Lum. For treachery, we found another Shale at run 5. Where was the first one? Run 3. Okay, so run 3 was the first Shale for Rhyme. Run 5 was the first Shale, or the second Shale, which was going towards treachery. I found a Thal on run 10, which was the second Thal, because the first one was run 8, which was used for spirit. And then we needed a Lem to make treachery, and we did not find one. So unfortunately, we did not make a smoke or a treachery for our mercenary early on into this game. But as you guys can see here, within 8 runs, I was able to make myself a spirit, insight, and rhyme. Now, again, I already had a spirit before I even started Countess because I got extremely lucky. But nonetheless, I got the runes even if I didn't have them. Another key tip here is if you do the Frigid Highlands quest in Act 5, quest number 2, where you rescue the soldiers, that quest will actually give you a Ral or Tal, which will save you time from having to get them for your spear and insight, or Ancient's Pledge if you're using that instead of Rhyme. So overall, you can do that as well, which I ended up doing, which is one of the reasons why I got the spirit so early. But overall, that's the information in terms of targeting rune words, the main objective of doing Nightmare Countess. Alright guys, now we have made it to the final part of the video where I discuss exactly what has dropped from the Countess. So as you guys can see here, I was targeting particular rune words and hell runes. So here I have 7 hell runes, which dropped on 6, 10, 13, 31, 64, 83, and 98 in terms of the runes that they dropped on. Now I have flawed emeralds here as well. That's actually supposed to be chipped emerald because 3 dull runes and a chipped emerald will actually give you a hell rune. And since we are looking for hell runes to reroll rune words, I figured I would throw in the chipped emerald. I don't know why I put flawed there, but it's supposed to be chipped emerald. So very rare that they will drop, but I do think it's worth noting in case you did not know that recipe is such a thing. Now, in terms of spirit runes, we have 37 Tal runes that dropped out of 100 Countess runs. We have 13 Thal runes, 28 Ort runes, and 20 Am runes. So just off these, we can make 13 spirit swords out of every 100 runs based off at least my video here. In terms of insight, we found 21 Ral runes, 15 Tear runes, and 20 Soul runes. In terms of Tal runes, we found 37, as I mentioned earlier. Now, if we were to make 13 Thal runes, that would give us plenty of Tals left over to make, I don't know, maybe 15 insights, because we have 15 Tear runes, which is the lowest out of the amount we have in terms of that rune word. In terms of rhyme, that is a shale and eth, which we have 14 shales and 13 eth runes, so that allows us to make 13 rhyme shields. And for the general runes that we don't really have in terms of main targeted rune words, I found 9 eth runes, 7 hell runes, 6 dull runes, which can turn into 2 hell runes, so technically 9 hell runes. And then we have 1 eld rune, 1 eld rune, 5 Neph runes, and 1 Io rune. So the highest rune I found here was Io. No Lums, no Lems, no Coes, nothing specifically for those decent rune words in the mid-level, like Smoke and Treachery. I was hoping to make a Smoke or Treachery either for my Mercenary, or at least a Smoke for myself, but that doesn't appear to be the case. So we didn't really run into any luck regarding those particular 2 runes, but we can definitely upgrade up there with the amount of low runes we have here. That's going to take a lot of work, but I think the main objective here is that we found 232 total runes in 100 Countess runs. We are able to craft 13 spirits, 15 insights, and 13 rhymes with the ability to reroll 7 times on any rune word. So if we find a 25 faster cast rate spirit rune word, we can reroll it with one of the hell rune recipes, and then we can try again for hopefully a 35% spirit, and then sell that for a lot more. So that's basically what the objective was in terms of this magic find run as myself, and in terms of Battle.net, maybe this is some good information for you guys. I hope this information was good. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you on my next one. Bye guys.